Hello YouTube, this is a follow-up video on my S9 antminer series. Please check those videos to learn what comes with the antminer S9 from Bitmain and how to set up the antminer S9 Bitcoin miner power supply. A few days ago I received a request from one of my subscribers on how to mine with a Bitmain antminer S9 cryptocurrency coins other than Bitcoin. If you're mining or you want cryptocurrency mining ASIC dedicated hardware, in order to maximize profits, you should be checking daily what coins are more profitable to mine for the algorithm your miner hashes. In this case, SHA 256 for the antminer S9. After browsing to whattomine.com, I discovered today that digibyte or DGB-SHA is the most profitable coin we could be mining today, based on complexity and market price. Digibyte is a very singular coin, since it can be mined with multiple algorithms, SHA-256, Skein, Qubit, Grossel, and Script. Each algorithm is better suited to different types of mining hardware. SHA-256 and Script are now almost exclusively mined by advanced ASIC miners, like the antminer S9. Skein and Grossel are good for GPUs, and Qubit is a combination of multiple types of hardware. To mine any cryptocurrency, you will need an account with a pool. Let's create an account with the blocksfactory.com mining pool to then show you how to configure the antminer S9 to mine with this pool. Browse to the blocksfactory.com and click on the coin, in this case Digibyte, an algorithm you will be using to mine. In this case, since it is an antminer S9, let's click on SHA-256 and then click on register at the top menu. Select a username, a password, an email that you will need to enter twice, and a 4-digit security PIN. Let's log in. Once logged in, browse to workers under the My Account top menu, and you will need to create at least one worker with a password under your account. You can name it anything you want. This password does not compromise the security of your account, and you can put whatever you like. Checking on my antminer S9, the details for the first pool where you will need to enter the pool details are already filled with the previous experiment with it mining nice hash. Check that video linked in the description to learn about NiceHash profitability. We will need to change these parameters to the block factory pool parameters for Digibyte mining. To do that, click on servers at the top and copy the field stratum URL. This is the server address you will need to enter on your S9 and miner configuration for pool number 1. Prefix it with stratum plus TCP on the URL field for the pool 1. For the username, you will use your username, that worker name, and the password you enter for the worker. Click on the save and apply button once you enter all the details. Let's wait for the antminer to reboot with the new pool details. Once the antminer S9 comes back, browse to the miner status tab where you will find the blocks factory pool status listed as alive. Back on the pool, refreshing the my worker page under the my account top menu tab, and you will see the hashing speed increasing as the antminer S9 hashing power kicks in. It will slowly go up until reaching the 14 tera hashes that the antminer S9 is capable of. After 2 days probably and a half that I've been mining, pretty much I have made a profit of more than 4,000 digibytes. So let's go to my payout, to the transaction history on the pool, and let's take a look at the withdrawals. And pretty much it has been depositing every time that I make more than 1,000 digibyte, it has been depositing this amount. So on the first payment, You start mining early on the at midnight on the 4th. So pretty much I ended up like 4 hours into 06, which will make it 2 full days plus 4 hours. So that will be probably like 2 days and a sixth of a day. And I still have remaining here 500 digibytes. Pretty much if we pull an Excel sheet out of this data, we're gonna see that since we changed to digibyte, we made, let me open Excel here. If we had mined more time, probably we'll have made a little bit more, but we only mined for 2 days and 4 hours. These are all the transactions. They add up 4,021 digibytes withdrawn. There is still remaining 500 digibytes on the pool that I can take out, and I had left previously 771 digibytes on the pool. So the total profit after we add up those two and subtract what was there already, we mined 3,749 with 74 digibyte for 2 days and 4 hours. That will be the equivalent to $24 with 66 cents. If it comes back to the price on December 3rd, 2017, then with my antminer S9, I will have mined $26 a day. Or $24 with 66 cents today, if I sell the price that the digibyte is today on the market. I could exchange it for bitcoins and pretty much have a total of $55 with 49 cents mined for 2 days and 4 hours. And that's what you get when you switch to digibyte when the price was up at 16 cents. It went down by a cent now, by not a cent, by 0.001 cent. But that's the end of the experiment on mining digibyte when it was up on whattomine.com. Pretty much today, if we go back to whattomine, today with a antminer S9, the best choice to mine is NiceHash by a few cents over Bitcoin. Bitcoin price has been going up, is more than $12,000 now on December 2017. And pretty much that's the highest that it has been. Based on whattomine.com, the price today is $12,467 per Bitcoin, which is really high. Okay, guys, that's pretty much all I have. That's the result from mining digibyte for the few days that it was up. I've switched back to mining straight Bitcoin today because the price difference in between NiceHash and Bitcoin is not that great. So we're mining Bitcoin today on the slush pool, and I'll make a video about that in a few minutes. Let me see what we are starting with on a slush pool so I can update this video on what are my profits over there mining Bitcoins. Let me log in. So this is the slush pool, my account. Pretty much I just started mining Bitcoin on this pool again today. This is what I have as an unconfirmed reward. Let's update this video in a few days so you know how much I did mining Bitcoins when it was at a profit, expected profit of $32 with 58 cents a day, theoretically. Please hit the like button on this video. Subscribe to my channel so you can stay updated every time that I upload a video to YouTube. Hit that notification bell so you know when I post the video. When you're subscribed, you will receive a notification. And I hope you have a great day. Happy mining.